I would like to give the floor shortly to Dr. Hubana Hoek. I hope I pronounced the name right. She is representing the Association of Bangladesh Textile Apparel Entrepreneurs. I understand that the association represents a group of companies which is exporting annually over 34 billion US in value, amongst others to the Netherlands, and we learned from the presentation from Zahed. However, next to textiles and apparel, members of this association are also eyeing to diversify the business, amongst us in the light engineering and manufacturing industries. Dr. Hoek, could you share your views on the considerations of members of your association?
Thank you, Matthias, for allowing me to speak, Excellency, and all the esteemed panelists. Bangladesh RMG industry, the ready-made garment sector, actually currently consists 84% of the export basket. So that is by itself an overdependence. In terms of economic complexity, in terms of product, process, and value chain, we are not at a very, very good place. So at this point of time, what we really, really need to do is make sure that we actually diversify very fast. And that's the need of the hour. So we've been within ourselves, we've been talking about it. And we've also suggested to our Bangladesh Investment Development Authority, BIDA, so that we can make sure that we have some kind of a structure like Vietnam did in terms of Sector Diversification Council, where we bring in, you know, MNEs and of course we link ourselves. Very often what happens is the SMEs are not linked to FDI opportunities. So for us, it's important that that we actually draw that sync. I can only tell you that only in our sector, if we consider light engineering, the RMG textile sector needs, first needs is capital machineries along with spare parts. These are all being imported right now. Currently, we are importing more than 100 spare parts for the industry, and imported spare parts almost equal to USD $1.6 billion. And that's what we have imported in 2018, 2019. And that we have imported for only top 27 items. If I have to break them down, I can only tell you that we have just imported washing machinery worth 271 million. We have imported 222 million worth sewing machines. We've imported $174 million worth of just air and vacuum pump, gas compressors and fans. We've imported $159 million worth of steam and other vapor generating boilers. We have imported $154 million worth of printing machinery, $136 million of filtering machinery, $75 million worth of central heating boilers, and $63 million worth of electric motors and generator. So that gives you a more or less an idea of how much we import. So we see an immediate interest from our sector to link with anybody who's interested in FDI. So any kind of joint venture would be more than welcome. Any kind of even 100% FDI would be welcome in Bangladesh, because light engineering is the way to go. And you know what? It also relates very well to our labor force, because with the next threat of the fourth industrial revolution, we also need to reskill our labor force, because we want to go into a value-added production. So for us, it's very important that we move towards that direction. And I can also tell you that so far, what has happened is, in terms of FDI, the possible synergies could happen in direct infrastructure, meaning you can basically set up your industries here, or you can do knowledge sharing, knowledge transfer. You could impact us in a lot of ways. We are open for consultancies. We are open for joint ventures. And you know, we need to make sure that you come into this country. And yes, there are lots of challenges and there are lots of hiccups, but which country in the world doesn't have hiccups? Rather, you have a competitive labor force here. You have an extremely willing government, which is now setting up so many special economic zones just to welcome you. So it makes a sense. And as you listen to the Dutch ambassador in Bangladesh, you will very well understand where his heart lies. And he's called us the Bengal Tigers. So it's time for us to join hands together as the biggest association leading basically the largest exporters front. I think it would be worthwhile for us to engage with you. And while I heard my other colleagues speaking about their partners in Bangladesh, I can only tell you that we offer the best that partnership can offer. You will find very worthy hosts here who will be your friends and your partners for a long time to come. So we welcome you all. Thank you.
Excellent. Thank you, Dr. Han. This is inspiring and a clear opening also for Dutch companies to engage in Bangladesh. And definitely your association and your members will be to be considered. So that was about, let's say, opportunities for diversifying next to textile. But if you look to a bit more closer to the textile industry, which you are representing, there might also be opportunities for further value addition. For example, in the Netherlands, we also have quite a strong design industry, initiatives such as the Amsterdam Design Week. Could you elaborate a bit on your experience of working with Dutch companies active in the textile and design segments, and which opportunities do you perceive for the coming years?
Thank you. That's an excellent question. So there are two things that we're really, really interested in. One is sector diversification. Another is product diversification. So I can only tell you that, you know, there is a disconnect between what we produce and export and what the world buys. For instance, you know, the world buys around $9 billion worth of just women's blouses, and we only supply around 300 million. So there is a disconnect. So what we need to do is, we are basically a very cotton dependent country. So we need to diversify into man-made fibers. So that is also a call for collaboration when we say that, you know, you could set up your backward linkage here, a man-made fiber-based textile unit, and we'd be happy to partner with you. And in terms of value addition, just within the current supply processes, what we can offer is, we can offer sampling, we can offer manufacturing, but yes, Amsterdam Fashion Week is very attractive for us. And so far, the Dutch have been very, very supportive towards even industrial safety in our case. So for R&D, you could join hands with us, and we would actually benefit very much, because there are two things which are missing massively in our supply chain. One is innovation in terms of design. We really don't have the exposure yet. We're great with basics, but we have the capacity with all our green factories where we don't get paid the green price. We have the capacity to expand, to have more complex production processes and have more complex product. So in that, if you could partner with us, we would more than welcome your input there, and you could perhaps take us to the next level. But the second point is, of course, branding Bangladesh. And we have just launched a new slogan for our industry, and that is hashtag go human, go green. That is another part that you can actually help us. There is a direct link between a consumer and sustainable lives and livelihoods in Bangladesh. I'm talking about the workers. So that's a story you can help us tell the rest of the world. So I hope that by knowledge transfer through R&D and by branding Bangladesh, you will be by our side, and that we can actually make it to the global front. Thank you.